Hello friends, this is Shivli and you are welcome to my kitchen. Today I'll show you how to make Indian street style potato samosas. Now I'm showing you one of the samosas I have made. Listen to its crunchiness. You will get it how much perfect it is. Listen. Now I am breaking it. See the inner side of the samosa. See friends, it's so much delicious and so much tasty from the inner side and so much crunchy from the outer side. So let's start the recipe. I have taken a bowl and a strainer. I am adding 1 1/4 cup of maida, that means all purpose flour, and we need to sieve it. Now add some carom seeds, salt to taste. I am adding less than 1 teaspoon of salt, and now I am adding some refined oil, refined soybean oil, and we have to mix it properly. I am adding a little more refined oil and mixing it properly, just this way with my hand. The flour should be like this when I press it with my hand, and we can break it like this. Now I have taken a cup of water and I have to make a dough. We'll add a little water at a time. Don't add so much water at a time. We have to make a little tight dough. I mean a little tighter dough than the dough for chapati or roti. Our dough is fully ready, and see, half cup of water is left and half cup of water we have used. Now we have to leave the dough for rest and let's go for the potato filling. I have turned on the heat and I am adding some refined oil in the pan. When the oil is perfectly hot, we are going to add some cumin seeds, about 1/2 teaspoon of cumin seeds and 1/2 teaspoon of mustard seeds, 1/4 teaspoon of fennel seeds and 1/4 teaspoon of fenugreek seeds as well, 1 pinch of asafoetida. When everything is fried well, we have to add some finely chopped onion. Here I am adding 3 medium sized onions finely chopped. Stir it properly, and now we have to add salt to taste and 1 tablespoon of ginger garlic paste. Here I am adding crushed ginger garlic, 1 tablespoon, and now we have to fry it very well, because ginger garlic shouldn't be raw. The raw smell of ginger garlic must be away. I am adding a pinch of turmeric powder and stir it properly. Now I am adding some boiled chickpeas. I soaked them overnight and in the morning I have boiled it with potatoes. Along with the chickpeas, I am adding some finely chopped tomatoes. Here I am using 1 medium sized tomato. Now we have to stir them properly and fry them for 2 to 3 minutes in low to medium heat. Actually we have no problem if the onion has its crunch. And you can add the green chilies here, but I am not adding it here. I will add it later with the potatoes. Everything is fried well for 2 to 3 minutes in low to medium heat, and it's the time to add some powder spices. And I am adding 1/4 teaspoon of black pepper powder, 1/2 teaspoon of amchur powder, that means dry mango powder, and 1/4 teaspoon of garam masala, that means royal spices mix. We have to stir it properly, and now it's time to add the boiled potatoes. Here I took 4 medium sized potatoes and boiled them in pressure cooker, and after that I cut them in the shape you can see. And along with the potatoes I am adding green chilies here according to taste, and now we have to mix it properly. And when we are mixing the mixture, we have to mash the potatoes. Just this way I am doing it. And the heat should be low at this time, because we don't want to burn this mixture. See friends, our filling is ready for the samosas. And at the end of the cooking process, we have to add some fresh coriander leaves and some dry roasted peanuts. Now we have to mix it properly and our filling will be ready fully. Well, our potato filling is ready fully and we have to turn the heat off and let's go to make the samosas. See friends, our dough is fully ready for making the samosas. Now we have to knead a little and then we will make the samosas. Now we need a surface and a rolling pin to roll the samosa sheets. I have taken a little portion from the dough and I'll roll it. I'll dust some plain flour on it and I'll roll it. We won't roll it in round shape. We have to roll it in oval shape like this. You can see it. We'll roll it in oval shape like this and then we'll cut it in two portions. Just like this. We'll divide it in similar two portions and we'll get two sheets for two samosas. And now I'm making one samosa. We need some water. Fold the straight side of the sheet just like this I'm showing. Add some water on the edge this way. And this way we have to make a pocket. It is attached properly because we have added some water to attach it. Now we have to open the pocket and we have to add the potato filling in it. See, this way I have added it. And now we have to seal the pocket. We have to add some more water on the edge this way. Just like this. And now we have to seal it this way. We have to pull the longer side and attach it with the shorter side this way. See friends, our first samosa is ready and this way we will make the rest samosas. Now we will make 4 to 5 samosas and go for deep frying them and then we can make the rest samosas. We will keep it in a plate and make the second samosa too. I am making the second samosa and showing it too. You can see it. It's not very hard to make samosas at home. So friends, definitely try this recipe at home and let me know your experience. And see friends, this way I have made the second samosa too. And let's go for deep frying them. We'll check the oil because we need medium hot oil to deep fry the samosas. The oil is perfectly ready to deep fry the samosa. Oil is medium hot. Now we will keep the heat low and add the samosas one by one. Don't add so many samosas at a time. I am adding 4 samosas at a time. And now don't stir them at all. Let the samosas float and then we will stir them. You can see friends, the samosas have started to float and move. See, now we can stir them and we will flip them this way and we'll fry them in low heat until they are of light golden color. Don't keep the heat high because if we fry them in high heat, the samosas won't be crispy at all. You can see friends, our samosas are ready and they are of light golden color. And now we will take them off from the oil and this way we will make the rest samosas. You can see the color is light golden and when we will take them off from the oil, the color will be a little darker. So we have to take them off right now. Just strain the oil out and take them off. We'll take them on a kitchen tissue or a kitchen towel and this way we will fry the rest samosas as well. You can see friends, my second batch is ready. They are also of light golden color, and now we are going to take them off just like the previous batch. And this way we will fry the rest samosas as well. You can see friends, our samosas are ready to eat. They are so much crunchy and so much crispy from the outer side and so much delicious from the inner side. Just like the samosas we get from the roadside stall. I am showing you one samosa. See its crunchiness, its crispiness. See friends, it's not so hard to make samosas at home. So please, please try this recipe at home and let me know your experience. Now I'm breaking the samosa and showing you the inner side. See friends, no need to say anything about it. It's so much delicious from the inner side. So no more today friends. We'll meet in the next video. Thank you for watching. Bye bye.